Measles are still a leading cause of children's death around the globe. And if you think that living in a developed country exempts you from the threat of infectious disease, think again. The Public Health Agency of Canada estimates that just 62% of Canada's two-year-olds are up to date on their recommended vaccines. In 2011, Quebec experienced one of the biggest measles outbreaks that North America has seen in two decades, with over 700 cases reported. The year before, British Columbia saw 82 cases, and this year, rates are up in Toronto. So, it is against this backdrop that NOSODs have come under increasing scrutiny. NOSODs are remedies that homeopathic practitioners use to treat diseases, including measles, influenza, and polio, and they're sometimes called vaccine alternatives. Hundreds of medical professionals, academics, and scientists recently signed a letter to the Minister of Health asking Health Canada to stop approving the use of NOSODs. That letter was part of an anti-NOSOD public awareness campaign. NOSODs are made by diluting disease-infected tissue, saliva, feces, or mucus, with alcohol. The disease is rendered harmless, but homeopaths believe it can trigger an immune response. And while Health Canada says they are not alternatives to vaccines, our next guest says that's exactly how they're being used. Dr. Lloyd Opel is the chair of the British Columbia Medical Association Council on Health Promotion. He published an article in this month's BC Medical Journal accusing Health Canada of diluting its standards by approving NOSODs. He says what Health Canada is doing is dangerous. He joins me now from our Vancouver studio. Dr. Opel, hello.
Hello.
So I just gave a brief description, but can you explain to our listeners in plain English what NOSODs are?
Well, NOSODs are preparations that come from infectious agents or disease tissue. They're then prepared in a way that dilutes them over and over and over and over again to the point where nothing of the original substance is left except for water. And then they are sold as though they could be used as vaccines.
And they're not vaccines?
They are not vaccines.
What are some of the illnesses that practitioners use NOSODs to treat?
Well, there's a whole gamut, and it includes some very, very serious diseases, life-threatening ones, anywhere from influenza to polio to whooping cough. There's many others out there.
And do you believe that they work or are effective in any way?
No, they can't possibly work, and the reason is that there's not even a single atom of the original substance left in them. It's really just water or alcohol or a sugar pill that you're buying.
So you wrote a very strong editorial in the British Columbia Medical Journal about Health Canada's role in okaying NOSODs. How widely accepted do you think your view is?
Well, I don't have any trouble within the medical or scientific community. That view is really not a challenge. But when it comes to making false advertising claims to a public that may not have the time to look into these issues the way that others have, then it becomes a real problem. And we know that in Canada, there is a very large market for herbal or homeopathic products, upwards of $2 or $3 billion a year. And there's major, major money behind this in terms of producers who I suppose are making the biggest markups known in history on homeopathic products, as there's no active ingredient left in them. But this is something that what we worry about is that the public will believe that these homeopathic vaccines are effective and then delay getting their children immunized or not get their children immunized, and then problems start.
So are you saying that Health Canada is protecting the market instead of the individuals that are being treated by these products?
Well, they certainly haven't listened to the concerns of the BC Medical Association or the Canadian Medical Association, where we've called for the natural health and homeopathic products to be subjected to proper scientific testing. That's a real gap in their responsibility to Canadians to make sure that if Canadians are going to buy products off the shelf, that they are at least making an informed choice. Mm-hmm. And what's not happening here is that Health Canada is not telling Canadians that these products are ineffective.
What impact do you think NOSODs have on herd immunity or immunization in Canada?
Well, we have a large body of literature that speaks to the concern that when you give out misinformation about vaccines, their dangers, or things that you might do to otherwise prevent the disease. If it's misinformation, we are concerned that there is a real link between that kind of misinformation and people not getting their kids immunized. There are papers published now that show that if people are getting advice from, say, alternative medicine providers, that they are less likely to immunize their children, and that those children are more likely to get those diseases and the lifelong consequences, permanent consequences of some of those diseases.
But
that's our concern.
But where's the misinformation coming from? Because Health Canada says they've not endorsed NOSODs as a means of providing immunity. They say immunization is the best method. And we spoke to a number of practitioners who say they don't use NOSODs as vaccine substitutes either. Do you think that reflects the way people who take NOSODs think about them?
Oh, not in the least. I think the people who take NOSODs are taking them in good faith and believing that these NOSODs are going to prevent or protect them from the diseases that they state they are. And let me just add that if you were to do, say, a simple Google search on these NOSODs, the only way that they are marketed and used is as vaccine alternatives or to reduce the symptoms of disease, but really they're being marketed as preventive measures. So if Health Canada says that they don't license them as vaccine alternatives, you have to wonder if that's a defensible argument. It's almost willful blindness because that's the only use to which these preparations are being put.
Do you think that consumers have to shoulder some of the responsibility here?
I don't really see that in that way. And the reason I say that is because we count on governments and national bodies to do jobs for us that we couldn't possibly shoulder ourselves. And to expect the public to have the time to check out the scientific research behind these things, I think is way too much. We pay taxes and we trust Health Canada to protect us by having real standards of safety and effectiveness, and that trust has not been borne out.
So Health Canada has approved somewhere between 150 and 170 NOSODs, and the majority of those in the last 5 years. So if what you say is true, if NOSODs actually pose a danger to disease prevention, why do you think Health Canada is approving them?
Well, that gets us into a bit of speculation here, but there is a large political influence on Health Canada. In the past, when there have been efforts at Health Canada to cut down on false advertising claims, there has been a vigorous industry response. In fact, the whole regulatory framework around natural health and homeopathic products was set up in a way that really sidestepped the scientific community. And it is written right into their own marching orders now that the standards of proof that are required for health claims on natural health products do not have to be as rigorous as they are for regular medications. And in fact, they may just come down to folklore or the opinion of providers. And that's a very big concern for Canadian consumers because we count on Health Canada to make sure that what's on the shelves truly is safe and is effective, and they're not doing that here.
But if there's a breakdown in herd immunity in Canada, do you think that some of that has to do with the widely debunked link between vaccines and autism or some of the other propaganda out there that's just anti-vaccine in general?
Oh, absolutely. I think that that link is real. The misinformation that was spread back in the 90s about MMR vaccine and autism is widely credited with the collapse of immunization rates in the UK and the subsequent rise in cases, sometimes with permanent and very unfortunate consequences for children.
So there's a not-for-profit group called Bad Science that's launched an online campaign called Stop NOSODs, and they have an open letter to the Federal Minister of Health there. It's been signed by over 400 academics and scientists and health professionals, and they're petitioning Health Canada to stop approving NOSODs for sale in Canada and to revoke the licenses of existing NOSOD products. How do you see the future of that unfolding?
Well, it really depends, unfortunately, on the political will to do so. I have no doubt that there will be a thorough thinking about this at the level of the Minister of Health and probably beyond her, whether it's worth the political fight to clamp down on those false advertising claims.
Okay, Dr. Opel, thank you for talking to us.
Thank you.
That was Dr. Lloyd Opel in Vancouver. Here at Day 6, we strive to provide listeners with perspectives from all sides of a story. Unfortunately, that's been a challenge with this segment. We reached out to a number of homeopathic colleges and organizations in Canada, including the Transitional Council of the College of Homeopaths of Ontario, the Canadian College of Homeopathic Medicine, the Canadian Consumer Centre for Homeopathy, and the Canadian Academy of Homeopathy. All of them declined our request for interviews. We also reached out to a number of prominent practitioners, and they wouldn't speak to us either. One Toronto practitioner who prescribes NoSodes as vaccine alternatives said she was worried she would lose her license if she did an on-air interview with Day 6. Health Canada also declined our request for an interview. They did provide a statement that says, quote, homeopathic medicines are not vaccines. Health Canada has not licensed any homeopathic medicine for the purpose of providing immunity to a communicable disease. We've put a link to their entire statement on our blog, cbc.ca/day6. And we want to know what you think. Are NoSodes putting public health at risk? Comment on the blog, cbc.ca/day6, or on Facebook or Twitter.